Hi, this is Julián from MinuteEarth. Dragons don't exist. But if they did, which would be pretty cool, they'd need to conform to Earth's biological and physical rules. So we figured we'd make a fun video about which of these famous fantasy dragons would have the best shot at being more than just fantasy. To rank these dragons' believability, we'll start with the most egregiously unnatural characteristic of dragons and move up from there. Look, obviously dragons breathe fire, but we looked into it and the only thing that even comes close to that in nature is the bombardier beetle, which fires boiling hot liquid from its butt to burn its enemies. Not exactly fire breathing. So let's just move on to the issue of limbs. Most Western depictions of dragons, like on the Welsh flag, have four legs and two wings for a total of six limbs. But all bony creatures, on land or in the air, evolved from a four-limbed fish whose body is the blueprint for every other bony creature, including a hypothetical dragon, clearly a bony creature. This would make it very unlikely for a six-limbed dragon to have evolved on Earth. That's why some fantasy writers, filmmakers, and game designers have used real bats, birds, and pterosaurs as models for their four-limbed dragons. So we're placing all these six-limbed dragons in the bottom tier, including the Smaug from the theatrical release of the first Hobbit film. The Smaug from the second film, however, gets to move on, since the filmmakers removed his front legs, not because they particularly cared about Earth's evolutionary history, but because they thought it would make for a more expressive performance. A wingless four-legged dragon would be accurate too, but without magical flight like in Eastern depictions of dragons, that's basically just the lizard. So let's talk about wings. Animals need them in order to fly, which means they need big chest muscles to flap their wings, which means they need a tall ridge on their specially modified sternums called a keel for the muscles to attach to. A dragon without a keel couldn't have the muscles needed to power fast enough flight to keep its massive body in the air. That means it's the end of the line for these smooth-chested beauties. But a keel alone is not enough to fly. Any creature that wants to fly also needs the right combination of weight, wing size, and flight speed. The more a creature weighs, the bigger its wings need to be, or the faster it needs to fly to generate the necessary lift to keep it afloat. For example, penguins, which do have a keel, could in principle fly despite their comically small wings, but they would have to go nearly as fast as a commercial airliner and deal with ludicrous forces on their wings. The Quetzalcoatlus pterosaur, thought to be the largest flying animal to have ever existed, had a 12-meter wingspan, which kept its 250 kilograms aloft at a reasonable 80 kilometer per hour speed. Naturally, we painstakingly calculated the weights and wing sizes of all our remaining dragon contenders and found they all had wings too small for their weight, meaning they'd need to fly at ridiculously fast speeds in order to sustain flight, and the forces involved would destroy any flesh and bone-based wings. Wait, so nobody wins? Well, among our remaining candidates, the most realistic has to be the one with the biggest wings in relation to their weight. And the winner is the Hungarian Horntail from Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire. It has four limbs, a keel to hold its muscles, and the biggest wings in relation to its weight. Now, whether or not you could ride it, we could get into that, but we don't want this video to drag on.
Did I just hear a clawsom pun?
Hey Matt, what brings you over to MinuteEarth from the extra credits side of the internet?
Well, Julián, you got me thinking. If the existence of these fantastical beasts are scientifically improbable at best, then how did a ton of cultures around the world each come up with dragon myths before ever having contact with one another?
Good question. Say, you wouldn't happen to, well, I don't know, have any idea where one could find a YouTube video discussing that very topic, would you?
You know, I just might. If you're fired up about dragons like I am, then come fly by the Extra Mythology Campfire, where we'll talk about dragon myths from various cultures, human psychology, dinosaurs, and even the politics of dragons.
Political dragons, huh? Hope they can let bagons be bagons.
Did we just become best friends?